And welcome back to the Buckeye State Wells. After taking a day off of whale fanning, we're back at the tracks on July 2nd. I will be back in Fosteroyal, Ohio. Today, however, this is going to be a lot of good trains today. Just starting of, like, whale fanning in Fosteroyal. I would see stuff in the Middlebury, but I didn't get it on a record. But, however, here comes I-151 from Detroit, Michigan to North Baltimore. He will be taking a while to go west towards North Baltimore.
Yeah.
I think you could tell that I was running from Poplar Street to go back to the park after hearing about 215 would take the curve to go north towards Walbridge, then working at Walbridge, then go towards Detroit. However, he would have a maze trailing second. I would not get to the crossing in time for getting 215. However, I got halfway to the park, and then here he comes. Just a mace is cool because, well, I don't see maces on CSX. And a lot of times, I well fit on CSX are either GEGLOs. So, this is kind of cool. I would definitely see more than this. Let's just get started. I was 51 with the first train. Here comes the second one. Eventually, we'll have another one because there is a green signal for an eastbound, so I'm guessing this is aisles 10. Here comes aisle 10. I think this is aisle 10, because you should go by here around noonish or 12:30. I didn't really know what time it came by, but I think it's close to noon 30. But, however, you know that maze that was trailing on M215? However, aisle 10, what I think this one is, has a SD70 maze that's trailing second. That would be kind of cool. L70 is departing Faustroya with a pair of SD40s, but he will be going pretty slow because he is coming out of VR. And second how, I don't know where he goes out west, but he does go out west somewhere. I don't know where he works, so I'm guessing he works like Fenley or Lipsick. That's my guess. Thank you. Here comes another westbound on the Garrett. This one will be a westbound intermodal stacks bound for Baltimore. I don't know what the symbol on this one could be, but either way, he's going to North Baltimore. He has two normal G-Lows as junk power. Here comes another train. This one is a manifest heading towards Cleveland. He would be M566. That would be my guess of the symbol. I don't have a scanner on me, so I would not tell what the symbols are whenever these trains are coming. But I do now since when I'm editing this video, I do have a scanner so I can tell what trains are which. Here comes a ethanol, taking the connection from the club itself. We'll be taking the Garrett to go west towards Bensonville or Chicago with 3448 and 316. Those power would be the power for this ethanol. He's going slow enough that he could take forever. Okay, now we have a westbound. Here he comes. Around the corner. I will be on top of something, but now. Of course, there goes a farmer going across the tracks while a train. Well, he was still pretty far distance, but you never, never, ever want to go across the tracks when the gates go down. You never know. Other trains could be coming. Maybe they've seen it, but yeah, I don't know. That's just my thought. Oh well. I'm over here minding my own business. But here comes 369. If you could tell, L70 is rapidly coming up, approaching. He is flying. I thought he would be going slow, going into the Fostoria yard. Flying yard. I guess not. Talking about this speed that he's going, he's just gonna go straight through, but he's gonna go into the yard at the other end. Wait, I don't know what the symbol on this one is. Whoever he is, whoever this train is, he is coming out of Fostoria, the yard. So, I don't know what is going on. I never usually see a freight coming out of the yard, unless they are doing some work. My guess, this could be 303 from Bellevue to Elkhart, but that's my guess. I have no clue. He has a fresh AC44 C6M, and then the UP Jibo 2nd. comes in eastbound on the Fosteria District. I don't know who could this one be after we had a westbound on the closest track, but this eastbound is on the closest track. But you know that westbound could have been crossed over to the right lane. So I don't know.
Thank you. Oh yeah, that's right. That's your dog.
Yeah.
I love your dog.
I do too.
Norfolk.
Norfolk.
Hi, buddy.
We got a train. There's Norfolk. And we got a train.
Oh, he wants up.
There it goes, or it's going by right now, but it's an intermodal heading towards Chicago with just GMOs. What I call it is Bevos, with just a long intermodal. I just took like many clips, so that's why it's long. Yeah, intermodal like these can be very long. This is a manifest that's going by right now. There goes foamers. A lot of foamers these days. However, this manifest is 370. Well, actually, I'm either debating what symbol this one could be. Whatever, I'll let me know in the comments. Let's just get the worst of this train. Thank you. Here comes a westbound, but this one would only have two of the CS6 units, and then two BNSFs. There goes Norfolk, my dog, which we take a lot, well, we're Royal Fanning, but he likes it. He likes being in the car with us. I drive now, so Let's just get those westbound. Here comes aisle 16 from Chicago. We would see this one go by Deschler. It's because it would have something trailing. I'll get to describe that in a minute. If you can see, 9280 is basically a white cab, standard cab. It's the only standard cab in CS6 system that is actually active right now. We're lucky that we have 9280 in standard cab. But it was CS6 7626 back in early days, but now it's 9280. Thank you.
in that train. It's a solo.
This is kind of random and immortal that is going by right now. We wouldn't have another NS for a little bit since the Garrett would be quite busy. There goes my dog going back into the car. I'm just filming the west of this immortal and talking to one of my friends that I was up top of this truck. Here comes another NS. I lied earlier that we wouldn't get any NS. Here comes another NS train. He is going crawl speed. I don't know if he like going into yard or doing some switching at Fostoria, the yard on NS, Fostoria District. However, it's a white face, white cab, that is leading this with an ace. This was very unexpected, being on the Fostoria District. A Herzog train, which is a ballast train. I don't know if they got empty or loaded, but either way, he's flying towards west, not the Fostoria District. I don't know if they're doing some track work on the Fostoria District. Either way, it's very cool to see a Herzog train on the NS. M201 from Walbridge to Chicago. He would be taking the Y, as always, to go to Chicago. He has a DC Gevo and then a Noble ES-44 Gevo. Everyone hates Gevos, but sometimes. But they're always leading on a freight, like M201. It's cool. Here comes another freight on an NS. This one will be a westbound. However, he would only have one solution that I would be surprised about. An NS leading with a dash 9. And you can see in a second. You know what? I'm just gonna spoil. Oil it way here. It's a Wells Fargo unit trailing second behind the NS-9. I was very surprised. This was my Canon 6D. I have two. One I used for pictures, one for video. I decided just to use this for this train.
Ready. This is a Chivo!
Tripboard!
I forgot to shoot the what locomotive. There's no weird DPU on the grand train, so I would just like shoot it with just the grand cars. I was almost about to scrap this footage with the grand train going by, but yeah. I just had foamers going off on the first clip before the grand train came. There goes the grand train. This would be the train that we would ending up sticking around for. This one is hour 37. He would have a special leader on this S Intermodal. He has a no hump boss car behind the solo engine. If you can hear the horn, it's probably not honking. It's actually not. But he's about to honk the Poplar Street crossing. But if you have not known about this unit, I'm going to say anyway. This is 4568, the Operation Lifesaver SD7 Mace. Was painted in Huntington. Well, after having a nice sunny day, this day would end off with a rainy night. we would still have a long drive back home. After getting I-137, we would just pack up our things and go back home. But unfortunately, today's video will be ending off here in Falls Joy, Ohio at the Poplar Street Crossing. I'll be seeing ya in the Buckeye State Wales or Michigan or State Wales.